Hey guys, GetLevel here, and today I'm going to show you how to set up your Twitch stream with OBS Studio and Streamelements. Now, there are many advantages to go with OBS Studio and also Streamelements. The main thing here is performance. OBS Studio is known to not use as much CPU as other broadcasting softwares, and with Streamelements, you can actually have overlays that are browser sourced, so they're not stored on your computer, allowing things to run a little smoother. I'm going to be covering everything from creating your scenes to getting free overlays from the Streamelements website. And in case you didn't know, I also stream on Twitch, so go follow me there at twitch.tv/getlevel. Right before we start, a quick message from our sponsor. Hey you, are you looking for emotes? Then you need to check out Own's Emote Maker. Check this out. In a couple of clicks, I create one character and then Own generates the rest. All you gotta do is go to own.gg/getlevel, hover over sub emote in badges, and click emote maker. So try it out. That is own3d.gg/getlevel. Now, when you first install OBS, it should look like that. If you didn't go to the auto configuration wizard, you can still click on tools, auto configuration wizard, which is what we're gonna do. In my case, I'm just gonna create a new profile and call it Streamelements. Click OK, and now it's gonna run me through the auto configuration wizard. So I want to optimize this for streaming. This is the theme of the video, so we're gonna click next. Base canvas resolution is gonna be the actual resolution of your monitor. So if you have a 4K monitor, pick 4K. FPS, either 60 or 30, but prefer 60 when possible. Click next. And then the service here is going to be Twitch. I recommend you connect your account. It will make things way easier. It will allow you to display your chat, and you will also have access to a part of your dashboard. So just enter your Twitch name and password. Okay, from here you can click next. And it will run basically a test on your computer to see what are the best settings, really.
A few inches later.
Keep in mind that this will really, really depend on your internet connection and your hardware. In my case, video bitrate is gonna be at
500.
Because I'm on ADSL right now and my internet really, really sucks. So in your case, you will probably have way better settings than this one. Click apply settings, and this should be enough for you to have a stream that doesn't lag. If you have a bad internet connection and some bad hardware, the stream might not look great. You might have to stream at a lower resolution, but overall, with this auto configuration wizard, you shouldn't be dropping frames, for example. On the right, as you can see, there's my chat. I can click accept, and you can drag and drop this wherever you want. I'm gonna put it to the side here. And then on the right, this is like my dashboard. So if I wanna change the stream title or anything, I can do it here. All right, so we're gonna create our four scenes. That's what I said, starting soon, intermission, gameplay, be right back. We're gonna rename the first one by right-clicking, rename. Call it starting, click the plus to create a new one, intermission, third one is gameplay, and fourth one will be BRB. And inside those scenes, we will have sources that will be like layers, and this is the source list. Right now, my audio mixer is not picking up anything. Two things that we usually want is desktop audio and your mic audio. Desktop audio will pick up anything that goes through your headset or your speakers, and then the mic is your mic. So let's go to settings. And let's go to audio. So as you can see here, desktop audio is disabled. We actually want this to be default if that's what you want, but if you have a specific headset, you can pick that. So everything that goes through the default, this is the Windows default, right? Your viewers will be able to hear it. Mic auxiliary, I suggest you pick the exact mic that you're gonna use just to make sure that Windows default doesn't mess it up. In my case, I'm using the mic mono right here. I can click apply and magically they will appear right here. And as you can see, it is totally picking up my mic right now. Since there's no videos playing or no gameplay in the background, there's no desktop audio. All right, before we start with Streamelements, one thing that you need to know is for sources, you can add them here, and you have different types of sources. Usually from here, as I talked about in a full tutorial on OBS Studio, you can actually set up all of your overlays without necessarily needing Streamelements, but those will be files and stuff that will be straight from your computer. The advantage that we have with Streamelements here is that everything can just be from one single source called a browser source. So it's basically your animated overlays, everything, your alerts is all coming from this one link from the internet, lowering the resources from your computer, basically. So we'll come back here and we're gonna go on Streamelements and try to find a free starting soon overlay for our stream. So you go to streamelements.com, of course, you log in with your Twitch account, click authorize, and on the left under alerts and overlays, you should find theme gallery or my overlays. If you already have overlays, this is where you'll find them. And theme gallery is all the overlays that Streamelements will propose to you, basically. So here, super themes are a full package for multiple scenes. Using a super theme will create five overlays that that you can use in different scenes in OBS. So technically you can create one super theme and you're set. There's a Valorant one right here. It's seems to be animated, so just click create. We can name it. Let's name it Valorant. And boom, create my overlay. It just gave you a preview of everything, and now it gives you a link. So technically I could go in every single one of my scenes, just copy this and add it as a browser source, and my overlay would be set. We can actually try that. Let me click on this, go to OBS Studio. My starting soon screen is selected. Click plus, click browser. I'm not even sure that's the that's the starting. Call this one starting overlay, press enter. Replace this link by that new one. Width and height, we want this to be 1920 by 1080. Remember, that's our canvas resolution. And click OK. See what happens. Wait a couple seconds. And that was actually the gameplay link. But don't worry, you can see this is animated, but also there are customizable stuff here. So we're going to delete this and make sure that we're actually adding it to the right one. Or something that I could do here is copy and just add it to the gameplay. Right click, paste reference, and then just delete it from the first scene. Remove, boom. We're also gonna rename it in order to avoid confusion. So this is game overlay. It actually says it right here, I just didn't see it. Animated talk, this is usually the intermission screen. Let's do this fast. So browser. Same thing, 1080p. That's the intermission. And this is the starting soon. There's an animated be right back. Let's click on this and add it to the be right back. Okay, that was easy. The only thing we have left now is to customize it a little bit and add a couple of sources. For example, the gameplay, we would want a game capture and also our webcam here, intermission, we want our camera, we want the game. So let's go check it out. So back to the Streamelements website, you can click see themes in my overlays. And those are old overlays that I have, but if we scroll down, we actually see the Valorant theme that it installed. If we go to edit the starting soon, for example, we can click edit and we can see the separation between all the elements. Right? To the left, we have the layers and they are smartly named. As here, you can see social edit here. This is where you actually edit your social. So text, Facebook, instead of having Facebook, you will be able to put your actual tag. For example, Twitch here, we're gonna click it once. Now, if you double click, you're just gonna change the name of the layer and not the actual text. So you click it once and then under here, you gotta click on settings. And this is where you can change the actual message. So I'm gonna put my own Twitch. And as you can see, it's updating to the right. One thing you need to remember is to save every single time. You click save and this would be updated on our OBS. So if we go back to our OBS, you can see it says guy level here. All right, I'm not gonna do it for all of them. I think you get the point. You will have to do it on every single scene though. Now let's add our camera. Let's go to the intermission scene here and let's click plus. We're gonna click a video capture device because that's what our camera is. You can name it whatever you want. This is the wrong camera. Let's click the right camera. It should appear here. And this is where we're basically going to be using OBS Studio. First of all, I don't like the way it's facing. So I'm going to right click on my camera, click transform, go to flip horizontal. So I'm facing this way. It's just more natural if I'm facing towards the gameplay and the chat. And I'm going to drag and drop it underneath my overlay. See how it's transparent? In order to not accidentally click on the overlay, because we don't want that to move anymore, we're gonna lock it right here. And now I only have control over my camera, which I'm gonna drag into place. If you wanna zoom in or anything, like you can, you know, make it bigger and just make it fit. If it doesn't fit, you can hold Alt on your keyboard in order to crop. For example, I can do this, right? And there you go. You can hold shift to stretch, but you shouldn't be stretching your camera. And for the game capture, it would be plus game capture. Click OK. And you can either capture any full screen application or capture a specific window. I don't have a game up now, but it will be the exact same setup as the camera. So you'll click OK. It will be full screen. You'll drag it underneath the overlay that is transparent, and then you'll size it to be over there. Just for the example, what I'm gonna do is pull up like some videos of gameplay. And here you can learn how to set up a video, just a random video. It's gonna be media source. So plus source, media source. I'm gonna loop this, click OK. So don't get confused, this is not a game capture, this is a media source because I'm playing a video. So I'm gonna drag it underneath the overlay as we talked about. I'm gonna size it to fit in place, just like that. Okay. Another huge advantage with using the free themes from Streamelements is that all your widgets are pretty much already there. If I type in chat, for example, you can see that my chat actually appears here. For a sec, it took a while there. I was kind of scared it wasn't going to show up. So if we go back to layers, I just want to make sure I have an alert box. I do. So I'm going to click down here on emulate and follow event to see what will happen. And just like that, basically my follower alert will show up here. You heard it twice because it's actually showing in streamelements.com, but also on OBS. So for your gameplay, you do the exact same thing. We're gonna go ahead and find a video capture device. Now we already have it. We already have our webcam, so we can click add existing, pick the one that we already added, and just put it in place. We see that that's the webcam overlay. I can still right click and flip it. All right, it still needs to go underneath it. Just like that. As you can see, there's a spot to put your name. I showed you how to edit those. And once again, you can hold Alt on your keyboard and drag the sides in order to crop so it matches perfectly. For your gameplay, you can add a game capture source, the same game capture source that you have on the intermission, for example. In my case, it's a video playing. It's not a game capture. So I'm going to add it. Add existing. Click OK. It's going to be full screen. I'm going to drag it all the way down now because I want my camera to be on top of my gameplay, right? Crop this a little bit more. And there we go. Now, the only disadvantage that you will have with Streamelements is that everything is on one browser source. So while I'm streaming, if I want to move the social media or turn it off, I would have to go to the website, find it, and then turn it off from there, which can be annoying. But it's such an advantage to be able to edit all the specific parts and also have all of it be in one single browser source that is not playing from your computer where you would have like a huge file. And that is how you get a full Twitch overlay setup in just a couple of minutes with your starting soon, with all your widgets, with your chat box, with your alerts, with your stream labels, and even your social media already set up in one source. Now I'm kind of new to Streamelements, so if I did any mistakes or if there's any better ways of doing that, please let me know in the comment section below. But I do believe that right now it is the fastest way of having a full setup that looks this good for live streaming. Now, if you would like to know how to set up OBS Studio with Streamlabs as your service provider, I also have a video on that subject. In that video, I also show you how to set up OBS Studio with every single overlay. Basically, your sources will be separate and will be coming from your computer. So if you want to download other overlays for free or very, very affordable, you can go to gumroad.com/getlevel. As I mentioned, I also stream on Twitch. I'm mostly playing Apex Arenas right now, so feel free to check me out. But that's it. Top right, YouTube will show you which video you should watch next, and at the bottom of it, you will see my most recent video. So go check him out, keep on learning about live streaming, and I will see you guys next time. Go out there, make me proud, get level out.